A few times every year, we hear stories in the media about how video games encourage violence and how certain games should never have found their way onto the shelves of your local video game store. These protesters do everything in their power to make sure a video game gets banned for whatever reason they see fit. Well, sometimes these protests actually work, and games that have no need to be banned will have the Executioner's Axe come down on them. Before we begin, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our content and ring that bell to become part of our notification squad so you never miss a video. Without further ado, here are 10 video games that were banned for shocking reasons. Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter 2. What's really interesting about the Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter 2 ban was that it was specific to one province in the country of Mexico. The province of Chihuahua was the only area in the world to ban this game. No, it wasn't because of any violence toward these cute little Chihuahuas. It was because the governor of the province accused the game of stereotyping the locals and deemed the game antagonizing. Did the governor of Chihuahua actually expect the developers to go to the province and study the way locals act? Come on! Games often stereotype large groups of people, so they should really lighten up. Even the mayor of Juarez, the biggest city in the Chihuahua province, chimed in and said that the game would scare off tourists. Now let's be honest, who would want to visit a city with one of the highest murder rates in the world? Yeah. Typical of politicians to blame an issue like the lack of tourists on a video game. Pretty much everyone on Earth would agree that it's not the video game affecting the declining tourism sector of the city. It's something much more important, which actually requires effort to fix. That won't be the last time that politicians are involved on this list. The entire God of War series. If you ask the country of Saudi Arabia, there can only be one god, and it certainly isn't the God of War. The entire God of War series was banned in Saudi Arabia because of the use of the word God in the title. Now, it's a religious thing, so it makes perfect sense for them to do this. But there are many other reasons that the game got banned as well. Saudi Arabia is a very conservative country, to say the least. When the government found out that there were some very suggestive scenes in the series, which were even interactive at some points, they had enough and made sure that it did not reach any store shelves in the country. There's nothing even Kratos could do to make this series a part of Saudi culture. That being said, this is the same country that banned the Pokemon trading card game for promoting Zionism, so they're a bit touchy when it comes to censorship. Luckily, there are some ways for the people of Saudi Arabia to get their hands on the game, but we won't be getting into it in this video. A quick Google search is what you're looking for. You can thank us later. Football Manager 05. You're probably thinking to yourself, how does a game like Football Manager 2005 find a way to get banned? We've thought the same thing ourselves. It's an innocent game about soccer, or football, or whatever they call it in your country. You just manage a team, buy and sell players, and try to win as many titles as you can. It's simple, good fun. It's not like there's a cheat code in the game to make a streaker run across the pitch in the middle of a match. What would a streaker even look like, considering all the players are just circles moving around a field? In the PC world we live in today, everyone gets offended by literally anything, and this is exactly what happened to the country of China. China banned the game from hitting retail store shelves because the original build of the game recognized Tibet as an independent country. I guess China decided to ban the game so it doesn't spark some kind of civil war between Tibet and China for separation. Seriously though, imagine if Football Manager 2005 was the reason for a war breaking out. Yeah, that would be absolutely ridiculous. But I guess China didn't want to take any chances at all. Battlefield 3. There are definitely worse reasons to bring down the ban hammer on a game than because the main story involves an invasion of your country, but Battlefield 3 still makes this list. In the story, American troops invade Iran. This got the game into hot water upon release in Iran, as many Iranian video game stores refused to sell the game before the official ban was even put in place. It's safe to say that the game didn't sell very well in Iran when compared to other countries. The Iranian government were not fans of the fact that you can have a gunfight in the middle of Tehran's Grand Bazaar. Turning one of their major tourist attractions into a war zone did not make them happy at all. Let's be honest, the relationship between the United States and Iran was already on shaky ground, and this game definitely did not do anything to help it. While it would be ironic for a war video game to start a real one, we think Iran has done the right thing, just like China did with Football Manager 2005. While a video game shouldn't start animosity between two countries, it's better to be safe than sorry and not even given a chance to. EA Sports MMA. An MMA game is going to have a lot of violence. There's no way to avoid it. The sport is literally two people beating the crap out of each other until one of them is incapacitated. You would expect countries to ban the game because kids might copy the actions they see on their screen and start using these violent moves on their friends. But that's not the case. Surprisingly, those flying knee strikes and head stomps are not the reason why Denmark banned the game. They banned the game because of energy drinks. Yeah, you heard that right. Energy drinks. In Denmark, energy drinks are deemed unhealthy, and all advertising for these drinks is prohibited in the country. That's not a bad law at all, considering irregular heartbeats and taurine shouldn't come standard with any drink. But it had an impact on this game. Considering EA Sports MMA had a big sponsorship deal with Rockstar, the game was never to see the light in Denmark. There are Rockstar logos all over the octagon, and even on the trunks of some of the fighters, so it's as if EA Sports was tempting Denmark to ban the game. Homefront. Homefront didn't make the best of first impressions when its TV marketing campaign consisted of using fake news footage to show America going to war with North Korea. Some people who watched the commercial actually thought that America attacked North Korea and started freaking out. When they realized it was just a marketing campaign, they took action and got developer THQ in some deep trouble. THQ even released 10,000 balloons into the air as a publicity stunt to promote the game. Since most of the balloons ended up in the Pacific Ocean, environmentalists were not happy at all with this stunt, and THQ got fined $7,000 for their actions. To top it all off, the game was banned in South Korea in an attempt to maintain the status quo in their diplomatic relationship with North Korea. What is with the trend of games almost starting wars? We feel like countries would be mature enough to not let a video game act as a catalyst to an invasion, but clearly South Korea is not taking any chances. They don't want anyone 50 years from now rambling on about what they did during the Great Video Game War of 2011, and rightfully so. Bully. Well, it took a long time to see a Rockstar game on this list, but here it is. This might not be the last Rockstar game you see in this video either. On the surface, Bully doesn't seem too bad. It's Rockstar's classic 2006 title about an English schoolboy trying to navigate through the social structures of boarding school. He'll progress through different cliques, including nerds and jocks, as he makes his way through the school year. Sure, the game may be called Bully, and the main character may be very aggressive at times, but there's no reason to ban this game, right? Well, if you ask the government of Rio Grande do Sul, the southernmost province of Brazil, they would disagree with you. The province brought the banhammer down on Bully shortly after the game was released. They argued the setting of the game would be potentially harmful to teenagers. Since the game is set in a school entitled Bully, this Brazilian province thought it would turn every student into a raging lunatic. The government even went as far as fining people 1,000 Brazilian reals per day for selling or even owning the game. Seriously, Brazil? There are so many games that deserve a ban much more than this one. Manhunt 2. Oh, another Rockstar game? Banned in South Korea, Germany, Malaysia, New Zealand, Italy, Ireland, and the entire United Kingdom. Manhunt 2 is not the most popular game. In fact, it's one of the most banned games ever published. As you can tell by the title, there's no surprise as to why. The first Manhunt game made a name for itself before release for being incredibly violent. Like, unnecessarily violent. Seriously, if these death scenes don't make you wince and look away, we don't know what will. The reputation of Manhunt was fueled by video game censorship activist Jack Thompson, who wrongly believed some claims in the media stating that the game had caused a real-life murder. It was all a hoax to deflect a bigger issue onto video game violence, but still caused these censorship activists to flex their muscles. When a sequel was announced, you bet they did everything in their power to ban Manhunt 2 in as many countries as possible. While the game did have gruesome and unrelenting violence, there are now even more violent games on the market with even better graphics. In the end, the activists won, and the game was banned in 10 countries around the world. Luckily, in North America, you can purchase this game without a hassle. Grand Theft Auto. Now it's just getting ridiculous. Three Rockstar games in a row? Anyway, the Grand Theft Auto series has been an easy censorship target since the first game was released in 1997. The series is known for their violence, suggestive themes, and coarse language, so you couldn't call yourself a censorship activist if you didn't hate this game. Although excessive violence is a staple of the GTA franchise, only one country has taken the drastic step of banning every single title in the franchise. Surprisingly enough, it's Thailand. They usually aren't very censorious about violence, but Rockstar Rockstar's most successful series of games is a special exception due to some real-life consequences. In 2008, a young man named Paul Wachino hailed a Bangkok taxi, and when it was time to pay for his ride, he pulled out a knife and attacked the taxi driver. He blamed Grand Theft Auto for his actions and said he needed the money to play it. He didn't want to pay the driver because, like many people in Thailand, he did not own a console or any games, so he had to spend money in an internet cafe to play video games. The government had to swoop in and prevent this from happening again, so they outlawed all of the GTA games from the country. Postal 2. Postal 2 is a game that pretty much allows you to walk around acting like a psychopath for a week. It didn't just get banned in New Zealand, it got its butt shut down. To be honest, the game was pretty gross. You could pretty much decapitate anyone you want and just hit people off the back of the head with a bat for no reason. The deaths were gruesome, it showed your character urinating and defecating, there was animal cruelty, it was homophobic, and even stereotyped racial and ethnic groups. Basically, if the game was one of those TV shows that issue a warning before returning from commercial break, the warning would last longer than the show. Everything that shouldn't be in a video game is in this game. The most interesting thing in the game is most of it can be completed without being violent at all. In fact, one of the features of Postal 2 is that it's only as violent as you are. That wasn't enough for New Zealand though, as even owning the game can set you back $50,000 and even put you in the slammer for up to 10 years. Imagine having a prison inmate ask you, "What are you in for?" and having to answer, "Because I own a banned video game." Yeah, we can't either. Wow. Some of these games got banned from countries for the stupidest reasons you could think of. Do you think any of these bans were just? Do you know of any games that got banned for shocking reasons that we may have missed? Let us know in the comments section below. Also, if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button to keep up to date with our playlist. Thanks for watching.